Hi, my name is Dave. I've been going to Sailorville Church since 2005. This is one of those good kid stories. Maybe it's something you can relate to. You see, according to my family, to my friends' parents, I was a good kid. I stayed out of the big trouble, if you will. I decided when I was in high school that I thought I wanted to be a pastor. Went to church every Sunday, was in the youth group, was even the church custodian. Problem is, I didn't know Christ as my Lord and Savior. In college, I struggled with a lot of the same decisions that college students do. It meant a lot of partying and just enough school to keep up. And I even had the audacity to go to Wednesday evening chapel at 8:30 and then went on to quarter beer night at 9:30 in the same night and thought this made sense somehow. At the same time, I found my way into the student radio station, and right away I knew this is what I wanted to do for my career. And after college, I found my way into my first full-time job, which was the Top 40 station in Waterloo, Iowa. And so in Waterloo, it's pretty simple. Work, sleep, eat, hit the bars. And eventually I thought, well, I probably should go to church as well. And so I started going to church. And in time, a friend of mine at work who had recently been saved, a coworker said, "I'll pick you up Sunday at 10. That's all she said. And so I was ready Sunday at 10. We went to church with her, and I experienced something I had never experienced before. I was in a church where people really lived what they believed. Their faith was not just something that they hung up on the hook as they walked out the door. They believed this. They lived this. And I was really intrigued by that. So eventually my Saturday night life had to change because I had to be ready on Sunday morning. Honestly, my story about my conversion isn't the story about a prayer I prayed. And sometimes that can be hard for people to understand because that's the nice, clean way to say it. The reality is my story is a story of God calling me and my response. One night I was talking with this same friend who was a coworker of mine about the Bible. And she said, "Dave, I'm going to say something unusual. God wants you to come closer." And the thing was, when she said it, I knew she said it, but it wasn't her that I heard. I knew this was God calling me. I said, "How do I do that?" And so she answered my question and she prayed for me. And I knew at that moment, that's what I wanted. I wanted to be all in with God. And that night I walked out and I looked around at the end of the evening and the sky was blue and the grass was green. And I knew it was true because God made it that way. And it was a cold, dark January night. The sky was not blue and the grass was not green, but I was alive because I knew that God really made it the way he said it was. So a lot of things changed pretty quickly at that point. I was going to church on Sunday mornings and they asked if anyone wanted to be baptized. And I knew I needed to do that, even though I had been baptized as an infant. So I called my mom and I shared that with her, and that didn't go very well at all. But I knew I had to share my story about how I had come to Christ. A few days later for Valentine's Day, I wanted to do an all request and dedication night. So I called my pastor and I said, "Here, was that love chapter at?" And he told me 1 Corinthians 13. "Why is that?" I said, "Well, I'm going to do an all request and dedication night. And I thought it'd be pretty cool to weave some verses from the Bible in with this on this Top 40 radio station." And I'll never forget the stunned silence. And he just simply went, "We'll be listening." And I think things were so new and fresh and different for me to live for Christ that there was an innocence. I just did them because I thought this is what I should be doing as a Christian. And I didn't realize how odd some of these things sounded. As I grew my walk with Christ, I understood that there was no such thing as a good kid. I was simply a sinner in need of a savior, period. And yet God's love for me was deep enough that he gave me a wife far beyond what I could have ever dreamt for. Rachel and I met on a Sunday morning, and literally we knew we were the ones for each other. We didn't know each other, but we knew you're the one. And 3 months later, through the holidays, we were engaged. We got married quickly after that. And then we came to understand what married life was about through the challenges and the difficulties and the struggles. We knew that we needed to lean on God as we grew together. Now, Rachel and I have been married for 18 years, and for whatever reason, we do one of the more stressful things you could possibly do in life as our way of spending time together, home improvement. And I think through it, we learn a lot about ourselves. We learn a lot about each other. Maybe you've heard it taught at Sailorville Church that God uses your spouse better than anyone else for sanctifying you. It's true. Proverbs 19:14 says, "Houses and wealth are inherited from parents, but a prudent wife is from the Lord." I think when you're in a more public figure kind of job, so many people see you in just that, and that's the problem. Because even as a Christian, even as a believer, that good kid thing creeps back in. I'm a good kid, I'm a Christian, I'm whatever it is, but that's not my identity. My identity is in Christ. My family is what matters to me. How I live within our church is what matters to me. How I function within our cell group, if I'm being vulnerable, those are the things that really need to matter at the end of the day. Because really, if we find our identity in, say, our job, God can take away that job at any moment. And I have to be all right with that because my identity is not in that job. Will people see me for who I am as a sinner saved by Christ or just in this job? And I think that's the good kid issue that I face today, that it has to be clear. My need for Christ is deep. And so is yours. And so if you're someone who says, "Oh, I've got that good kid thing going on too," then I would challenge you to say, is that how you're living as a good kid? Or do you realize your need for Christ in your life?